Good morning, students. I am Ankur Badhwar, and in this video we will be discussing about 5th and 6th April current affairs. As I promised, as there have been many requests by students that please make video on the daily basis, based on the daily PDF that we are providing, so I decided to start it. The video has got late today. It was just a backlog which I was trying to clear. So let's start with the PDF for 5th and 6th April. From 1 to 4th April, I have already given daily PDFs also given you weekly PDF, and I have made videos on the weekly PDF also. There are three parts. If you haven't gone through that, please go through those videos. It is in the description below, and there is a separate playlist in the channel also. You can visit that also for the purpose. So let's start 5th and 6th April for RBI and SEBI 2020. Okay, so first subfolder, as you know, I had divided the entire current affairs into 15 subfolders. So we'll be looking at what all current affairs were there. In these 2 days, like one was Sunday, so in Sunday already the current affairs are very less. Most of the news are from come from Monday to Saturday, and there is no important editorials and all on Sunday also. So as I told you, on Sunday I will be not providing any PDF, but whatever the news will be on Sunday, I will give it in Monday's PDF. On Sunday I will be providing you the videos for the entire week current affairs for RBI Grade B and SEBI Grade A. Okay, let's start now. First news is banking awareness, economy and finance section. Startup demand liquidity, lifeline to stay afloat. Well, this is common phenomenon. Even almost each and every sector is now demanding some kind of package or relief from the government of India. The condition is very worse. In fact, very bad, I would say. Let's see what is there. The startup wants public sector banks and state control. Should be the implementing agency of 10,000 crore funds of funds. So this current affairs we discussed in the previous week videos also. It was in the previous PDF also, the weekly PDF that I am providing you. And trust me, this is very very important from your examination point of view, for both for phase 1 and phase 2 of SEBI as well as RBI. One is SEBI is the implementing agency. The fund is of 10,000 crore. This figure is also important, and it is the known as fund of funds. Okay, so let's see what else is there. Yes, this is one of the other main important thing. I think it is only one financial institutions whose headquarter is in Lucknow, UP. That is SEBI. We did in the last video that we came out with the headquarters of IRDAI, Insurance Development Regulatory Authority. The headquarters was in Hyderabad, Telangana. We also did that of ICRA, the rating agency. Its headquarters was at Gurugram, and this is unique. SEBI headquarters are at Lucknow, UP. So you should remember that anytime the question can come in. Phase 1 especially, if we talk about, as you know that 4 to 5 questions came from headquarters in RBI Grade B phase 1 2019. So let's go to next news. GSTN processes 8k refunds and 20k registration in lockdown. So what government is doing, basically whatever the money is like the input tax credit which is due for the industries, MSMEs, and they are trying to clear it off at the early basis, so there is no liquidity crisis with the companies. Already they are reeling under the pressure of lockdown due to the coronavirus crisis, so they are processing at a very fast pace whatever is due to them. Now if you see this news, that they have focused 8k refunds or 20k registration is not important. This figure is not going to come. It will not come. Do not memorize it like this. The main thing which is important is that full form of GST, and we have already covered in the fiscal policy. When we covered the fiscal policy, in that we discussed GST in detail. There also we discussed about GSTN. We did discuss GSTN in banking and MMS static part also in the offering classes which I took. So in this, the full form can be asked anytime, and this is was not in use, but this question can be asked anytime. Infosys in been used like recently. I remember just a week ago or 2 weeks ago, the government has scolded Infosys because they are not able to properly manage this network GST, and that is a goods and service tax network. So this question can come anytime in SEBI and RBI Grade B, that who manages GSTN, and they won the contract in 2017. Since 2017 they are managing the GSTN entity. It is a database, it has already database of the GSTN, GST returns and all. So let's move to next current affairs, next news item. Let's see, deemed usage charge for not honoring green PPAs. Now this PPAs full form you should know, it is power purchase agreements. What happens that usually the renewable energy, the generation cost is more than that of the non-renewable sources like that of coal, etc. So what does government do that to have the renewable sector, like those who are producing the solar energy, wind energy, and these kind of renewable energies, the discoms of various state governments sign power purchase agreement with these producers of these renewable energy. Now what is happening currently is that whatever the commitment is there under this, they are not honoring, means they are not making the payments to these entities. The most foremost reason is the demand of the electricity is very, very low, and as a result they don't need this electricity at all, and also they are getting cheaply from the other non-renewable sources. So as a result they are not paying the payments. Now they are under huge stress, these renewable firms like Adani, I remember, has invested a huge sum in renewable energy, similarly Reliance also. So the government is trying to bail out these, and they are saying that if they don't buy the electricity, but they have to pay to these companies, and because whatever they are generating, that will be deemed as generation, and they have to pay the charges for that. The discoms cannot just say that we don't need your electricity right now because there is no demand. You have to take those renewable energy, you have to honor that contract. Now you see here carefully that it's not written here, but this PPA have been signed for the last 6 months only. It came into existence in last 6 months. Before that no PPAs were signed. Several many firms which are providing electricity from the renewable sources, but there's no PPAs. So there's a huge crisis there also. So government is trying to bail out them. So what is important from exam point of view is that they can ask you currently in use PPA, what are these? These are power purchase agreements that you should know. Nothing else is important there. Let's go ahead. That is the end of first subfolder. In 5th of 6th of April, only this much news was there in the banking awareness, economics and finance, which was important for your exam. Some other news items are there which I have deleted, that I don't think is any possibility from them coming because they were not so important. I am making this highly concise for you. It's very important you don't waste your time by doing unnecessary current affairs. So let's go to subfolder number 2, sports. No news, no important news, already no activities are taking place, so no important news in this sports subfolder for 5th and 6th of April. Let's go to subfolder number 3, that is the portal schemes and campaigns. Now let's see what is there. Center steps into about healthcare to the purest. It is talking about the Ayushman Bharat, the flagship scheme of the Modi government. Now there are two components on Ayushman Bharat, if you remember it correctly. One is the Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana, and there is one that is health and wellness centers. 1.5 lakhs health and wellness centers are going to be opened under this also. So this scheme has been done in detail. The basic parameters are that 5 lakhs of insurance will be provided to 10 crores of family in India, which will be equivalent to around 50 crores of population will be covered under it, and it will have 5-10 crores, 5 lakhs, 10 crores, 50 crores population will be covered. One more thing was there. It is only for secondary and tertiary care. It does not cover the primary charges. Okay, it covers only the secondary and tertiary hospitalization. We did in great detail in the scheme section, which we covered in the offline. Also, when I will be starting the ESA portion, I will be making the videos on these. In that, I will cover the Ayushman Bharat scheme in great detail. Okay. But I have already covered in the offline classes. If you don't know, please read it once from the sources available, preferably from the Government of India website. Anyways, we will cover it in the subsequent videos when we will start making the videos for the scheme for ESI, Economic and Social Resources of RBI Grade B. So let's come to next news. IPS IRS credit Karuna to shadow and aid Modi government's COVID-19 efforts. Now see here, Karuna, the full form is Civil Service Association in Reach to Support National Disasters. So yes, a remote probability, but yes, can come. It is not likely to come in RBI because RBI is far off now, but it can come in SEBI. So the chances are less, but still can come. So for that only. So that was the end of third subfolder, that is the portal schemes and campaign. Now we'll move to the subfolder number 4, that is appointments committees. No appointment or committee was there in these 2 days. So we'll move to subfolder number 5, that's the meeting, summit and event. Empowered group of ministers meeting today to discuss exit strategy post shutdown. Now what is this? Is basically the meetings regarding, now India is under lockdown for 21 days till 14th of April. Now Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has announced that that they are going to open in a staggered manner the economy. Maybe they are going to open or not going to open, there is no surety about that, but the meetings and discussions are taking place. So what will be the course of action after 14th of April regarding this empowered group of meeting has taken place. Now see, it was chaired by Home Secretary Ajay Bhalla. See here, it is not important who is the Home Secretary, who is the Finance Secretary, but yes, Niti Aayog CEO Amitabh Kant, this question can come. The question will be like, who is the current CEO of Niti Aayog, Amitabh Kant? You should remember this. This question can come anytime in your phase 1 exam, as well as may come in phase 2 exam of ESI in RBI Grade B, also in SEBI. Okay, so this was the only news in these 2 days from subfolder number 5. Now we'll move to subfolder number 6, no news. Subfolder number 7, again no news. Subfolder number 8, environment. Let's see. Yes, one news is there. Delhi breathes third week of clean air. Now, here basically they are talking about the AQI, which I have discussed in detail. They are around around 10 to 12 pollutants there, some of which are like PM 2.5, that is particulate matter 2.5, PM 10, NO2, SO2, like the C. Carbon monoxide and all these pollutants are there, and ozone is also there. So you should know what all pollutants come under the SAFAR app. Okay, you should know the full form of this, and you should know one important thing which we discussed in the sustainable development class when we took the offline class there. There I gave the notes also to you about the SAFAR app. SAFAR app is designed by IITM Pune. What is IITM? It is Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology. I repeat, it is Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, which is located at Pune, and it comes under the Ministry of Earth Sciences, which is currently headed by Dr. Harshvardhan. the Minister of MOES, Ministry of Earth Science. So all these things are important from examination point of view. What is AQI? It is Air Quality Index. There are different levels like from 0 to 50, 50 to 100, 100 to 200, 200 to 300. These all levels we have discussed in great details. I have given these questions in test also, and those who haven't attended my offline classes or the test must do that. They should know what is SUFFER, what is AQI, what are the pollutants are there, what is the full form, who have designed this app. This is IITM, where IITM is located. It is Pune. It comes under which ministry? It is Ministry of Earth Sciences. It is very, very important from your examination point of view, especially if I tag out RBI Grade B. Not only important for phase 1, but also equally important for phase 2 as well. Okay, so let's go to next subfolder. This is the only news in these 2 days from the subfolder environment. Let's go to next subfolder for subfolder number 9, no news. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, no news in these 2 days, which were relevant for your RBI Grade B and SEBI. Okay, so that's it. This is the new initiative that we will be making the videos, daily videos also based on the daily's PDF, and we are also going to make the weekly videos on the weekly PDFs. Okay, so my advice is that do follow daily PDF and the videos, and also follow the weekly PDFs and videos. The main challenge is that to retain in the exam, whether it is current affairs for phase 1 or the phase 2, retention is the main challenge. Once you do the daily PDF and do the video, then after that when you do the weekly PDF, it's just a revision of those daily PDFs, okay, and then you again watch the video, then it will get entrenched in your mind. So at the end of the time when your exam will come, you just have to revise these PDFs, these weekly PDFs once, and you don't have to go through the videos at that point of time, because it will take too much of time. But if you do it now regularly, religiously, daily PDF and daily video and weekly PDF and weekly video, it will be very, very, very useful for you for both phase 1 and phase 2. As if you're going to pile it up, and if you say that I will do at the end, it is not going to happen and it will be difficult for you. So if you like this video, please like it, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and click on the bell icon to receive the notification regarding new videos. We are putting new videos daily, almost daily now. 2-3 videos are coming in the YouTube, and we are also posting the link in the Telegram channel and other content also. I repeat, like I discussed in the weekly videos also, the weekly PDF videos, if you are reading newspaper, making notes, very best if you know what is important and what is not. But if you have problem in doing that, do only these two things. You read the important news articles plus editorials, which I am sharing in the Telegram channel on the daily basis. I am doing all the search work for you, and I am only sharing 4, 5, 6 important articles, news articles and editorials for you, and that will be sufficient. You don't have to filter the newspaper yourself, because I am doing it for you. Secondly, go through the daily videos which I am sharing. Along with that, go through the daily PDF. Okay. And this is what you have to do daily. And at the end of the week, on each and every Sunday, I will be giving you the weekly PDF and the videos. Go through that. The videos is very, very important, because in that I will tell you what is important from the PDF that you have to remember. From weekly PDF, it will not suffice. You have to go through the videos to understand what is important, what kind of questions are coming, what is important from the news also, and all those things. You just cannot blindly ratification of weekly PDF. That will be very harmful. Go through the videos to understand what is really the demand of the exam. Okay, so these things you follow. If you follow these things, you can skip the newspaper altogether. But if it is possible, please read one newspaper daily. If it is possible for you, Economic Times is a good one. It consists of very less of political news, and the Hindu, the Evergreen, you can read this also. Okay, so that's all. If you can, that is the ideal case I'm talking about. If you can, so that's all for today. We will meet tomorrow in tomorrow's video after I'll be sharing the PDF, and then I will be making the video, or maybe I will be putting the video first and then the PDFs. Till then, stay tuned, and we'll meet in the next video. Thank you.